For our final Woman Crush Wednesday, our guest is Willow Bay. She's the first female dean of USC's journalism school, and she's anchored on both ABC and CNN's Moneyline. I talked to Dean Bay about her career in journalism.
Dean Willow Bay, you've had an incredible journalism career, but also I know that you are a businesswoman, you're a former model, you're a mother. So tell me about your very first journalism job and what drew you to that.
My very, very first journalism job was when I was at the University of Pennsylvania. It was very brief, but it was at a local newspaper. The reason it was very brief is that I was working and going to school, so I couldn't do all three of those things. And so it led to a bit of a pause in my journalism career.
And so before that, were you always interested in journalism?
From the time I was a kid, I wanted to be a reporter. And I think I wanted to be a reporter. I'm not even sure I even knew what the word journalist was. Mm-hmm. I just loved the idea of telling other people's stories.
And what about that did you love?
I think I loved the learning of it, because how I've described journalism as an adult is it's the closest thing to going to school every day you can do for a living. Because every day you have to steep yourself in the world and its issues and get to know people and communities. And you come away every day with a new set of knowledge.
So I know that you were looking for an internship in journalism, and you mm-hmm. went and they offered you a modeling position. Is that correct?
Correct.
So tell me a little bit about that.
So teenager, really wanted to be a reporter. And in those days, 17 Magazine was the teenage Bible. We did not grow up in a time when teenagers consumed all sorts of media content across platforms 24/7. We had that one magazine. So I thought, well, great, I'll become a fashion editor. And so I went on an interview for an internship there. But it was the middle of the summer, and the editor said, okay, if you want an internship, you need to apply, you know, in the fall for next summer. But in the meantime, here, go here. We might want to use you in the magazine. So on a piece of paper, she scribbled this address, and I walked up the block, about 7 blocks, actually, in New York City, and walked up the block to Ford Models and began a modeling career.
Wow. So what was that first modeling career like?
The first assignment was for 17 Magazine.
Okay.
So that was my very first gig, and it was a spread inside the magazine in holiday clothes in the summer. Also getting your head wrapped around long lead time businesses, which magazines are, and particularly were in those days. And then, so I worked for 17, I did that shoot and was on the cover.
Okay. And so then when you finally got your on-air jobs as a journalist,
yes.
When did that come about?
Much later, after college, actually. So I went to college and then went to graduate school. And as I was getting out of graduate school, I thought it was too late to be a reporter. And then I thought, well, I still really want to do this. So let me see if I can give myself a year. I had enough money saved to see if I can make some headway in this as a career. And if I can, awesome. And if I can't, I'll know that it's just not meant to be. So I went to my agent and said, hey, I've got an MBA. I want to be a business reporter. And he said, no, I don't think it's going to work that way. I think people are going to hire you in the profession that they know you in, which is in fashion.
Oh, okay.
So I started doing fashion reports, mostly on live television talk shows. Like it was then Regis and Kathy Lee, which is now Kellie and Ryan.
Mm-hmm.
And so those were my early jobs, and I hated them because I really did not like fashion reporting.
Okay, and what was it about fashion reporting that you just weren't drawn to?
I did not care. I did not care. As much as I might like to wear nice clothes, I did not want to report on it. It was just not interesting to me.
Okay. So how do you think your MBA really helped you as a journalist trying to get that first on-air business reporting job?
It took me a long time to wind up in business news, but I think my MBA served me well as a credential everywhere I went. It indicated that I was serious about learning. It indicated that I was committed and would put in the time and do the work. And I did that job part-time. I mean, did that degree part-time while I was working. So I paid my way through my undergraduate career at Penn and my master's degree. And I think those things, in addition to the skills and knowledge that you acquire, really matter because they contribute to kind of the unique set of skills and attributes that you bring to the job.
So did you think you needed to get that MBA maybe to like give yourself a leg up in getting into the industry?
I got an MBA for two reasons. One is I was really interested in business, and I had an English major undergrad, so I knew that that would really round out my education. And the other was because I thought it would serve as a strong credential, particularly paired with an English degree.
Okay. Is there a moment in your career that stands out the most to you?
No, there's not one moment in my career that stands out the most. So tell me about what you're thinking. Like, what are you thinking? What kind of story do you want? What kind of memory are you thinking that you might want?
Maybe like at the point where you realize, wow, I finally got to where I want to be, and maybe because of two or three events leading up to that.
I never had any sense of where this career would take me. Truly did not. And I was fortunate enough to have had lots of opportunities that I could pursue. And so I think with each really interesting assignment, I had a different revelation. So I was co-anchor of a sports show, NBA Inside Stuff, which really gave me a front row seat to the NBA at an extraordinary time in its history, the era of Michael Jordan and the Bulls and their three-peats. Magic Johnson announced that he was HIV positive my first weekend on the job. I got to watch this league actually plant the seeds of what today is its contemporary and powerful persona. And I remember thinking at the time, wow, this is a front row seat to history. I remember when I got the job as co-anchor of Moneyline, it was the first time a woman had had that job. It was still a time when they said, wow, we don't know whether men want to get bad financial news from a woman. It's one thing when the markets are up, we're not so sure. I mean, literally, that's what people said then, and it wasn't that long ago. And I got to witness history. It was the height of the tech boom, in that era's internet boom. And I had people like Jeff Bezos coming on to announce that he was going to sell books online. I mean, wow. Think about that.
Right.
Or, you know, Steve Jobs before there were Apple stores, and companies that I had never heard of before. And I had to learn and like Inktomi and Akamai. And I had to learn and master that technology and in order to be able to be conversant about it on live television. Mm-hmm. And I thought, wow, you know, life doesn't get better or more interesting than this. And then I went up at HuffPost, right? Where again, I had front row seat to history as, you know, content exploded on the internet as things like blogs and then later search and social came about and reshaped the media industry. And I got to sit alongside Arianna Huffington and her co-founder Ken Lehrer and help support their vision of growth for the company. So I think at different points along my journey, I've had these pinch me moments.
So what did you tell people, men and women, maybe when they saw you in that seat, that business seat, the first co-anchor, what did you tell them when they kind of denied you because you were a woman going into business?
I didn't tell them anything. I did the job. I sat in the seat, put the mic on, and did the job. And I did it because I was incredibly prepared, I was incredibly curious, and I was profoundly grateful for the opportunity. And I think all of those things matter. You don't need to be perfect when you do these jobs. I learned on the air a lot, but people expect you to be prepared and really work hard and to take seriously the responsibility and privilege of bringing them the news every day.
Who do you admire most in your life, both professionally and personally?
My mom. My mom taught me to be a feminist from a very, very young age. We would talk about where I was going to go to college when I was probably 10 years old. My mom didn't finish college. So certainly my mother, really for creating expectations, for nurturing independence and integrity, and for really helping me understand that you could chart your own path as a woman, and it didn't have to look like what came before you. It could be your very own. I think I have worked for extraordinary men and women in my career from whom I have learned and learn every day. To this day, I'm still learning. You know, I sit here surrounded by my two school directors, Gordon Stables and Josh Kuhn, and I learn from them every day. That's one of the joys of getting up and going to work every day, is that there's still so many things to learn.
So who out of your career would you say like was your greatest mentor?
My greatest mentor. I've had a lot of mentors at different steps along my journey. So, you know, I would say in the early days, it was, you know, Mid Richardson, who was the editor-in-chief in 17 Magazine, who gave me a shot and gave me an opportunity in that business. Pat Mitchell, the legendary media executive at CNN, allowed me to talk my way into a second job there as co-anchor of CNN and Fortune Magazine. Why? Because she knew I would do twice the work as my male anchors, and I was the only one on that set with an MBA. Ariana Huffington, I mean, to be able to not just work alongside, but to consider myself a friend of one of the greatest media visionaries of our generation, just an extraordinary force of nature who has provided me with counsel and wisdom and still does to this day.
What does it take in terms of like passion and excitement and love for learning? What does it take to be a successful journalist today?
In some ways today, it takes exactly what it has always required, right? A relentless curiosity, ferocious, ferocious set of ethical standards that will not be compromised by the real world, which often intrudes. So curiosity, ethics, a relentless attention to detail, an enormous amount of compassion. Today, you add to that all the technological skills, which are different, and an ability to be fluid and well-versed across a variety of technologies and platforms, but also to always remember to be guided in your creation of journalism across those platforms by the same values, right? Truth, fairness, accountability, and compassion. That those should always be your guiding principles and not the technological platforms that you use to cover the news.
So what's it like being the dean of USC Annenberg?
It is both a joy and a privilege to come to work here every day, and I have felt that from the moment I set foot on this campus. First of all, to be at this institution, to get to learn about an entirely different world. I mean, when I first got here, I did say it's like a trip to Mars because the academic environment is so different professionally from the world that I came from. And that's a gift, right? To be able to use your cultural competency in learning and understanding an entirely different culture, same as you would if you were reporting somewhere that you'd never been or that you were unfamiliar with. I also, and I say this often, I love this generation of young people. I love your generation of young people, Gen Z. I think they are different and I think they are special. And I think that for all your skills, attributes, awareness, powerful sense of social justice, supporting you all and guiding you along your journeys doesn't just allow you all to live up to your potential, but will allow us collectively to live up to ours. So that's what puts a smile on my face every day.
What would you tell an aspiring young woman who wants to be a journalist or wants to be a business reporter or even a model, let's say?
I don't know that the advice that I would give a woman is any different than the advice that I would give a man, which is be true to yourself. If it doesn't feel right to you, it's not right. Exercise your curiosity. It's what will propel you, not just in your career and in your profession, but in your life, to be able to derive not just knowledge and information, but joy from the accumulation of knowledge and from learning things about the world and from meeting new people in the world is one of the greatest gifts in your life that you can ever have.
And my last question, what would you tell your 25-year-old self?
Speak up. I think one of the reasons that I was attracted to being a journalist is that I'm more comfortable asking questions than speaking in public or sharing opinions or even just frankly voicing ideas in public, particularly as a young person. So I would have told my younger self, use your voice, speak up.
And is there anything that you'd want someone to know about you that maybe they don't know behind all of the work that you've done?
For all of my public self, right, for all the jobs I've had, for all the kind of public-facing activities, the real place that I derive my greatest sense of stability and joy is at home. And that has been true always. And now it's true shaped by, you know, my 25-year marriage and two boys and two stepdaughters and five grandchildren. It's really where I return physically and psychically and spiritually to be grounded.
Thank you so much, Dean Willow Bay, for joining us here today.